All right, guys, what's better? A shorter run at a higher rate per mile or a longer run at a lower rate per mile? Let's get into it a little bit. Here we go. When you go on Facebook, because that's where everybody goes and argues with each other and helps each other and, you know, waste time and things like that, you know, it's a good thing. Very frequently, you see guys posting their rates per mile. I got 350 a mile for this load. I got 420 a mile for this load, okay? Almost always what's missing is how many miles did they have that load for, okay? Having a really big rate per mile, but not going very many miles, really doesn't mean much. You know, I'll give you an example. I had a rate per mile of about something like $1,500 a mile for loaded miles, okay? Why? I had a load that paid me 350 bucks. It was on my route almost. It was a little detour, but we're going loaded miles here. Paid me 350 bucks. It went a quarter of a mile. It was a drop off that was dropped off wrong. It had to be taken from one building to the next company around the corner. The two properties touched each other, but I had to go outside the properties. It was not quite a quarter mile. Okay. My rate per mile, loaded miles, was $1,400 a mile. Okay, beat that. Right? Doesn't mean anything. It's 350 bucks. Okay? You don't run your business on 350. That was gas money. It was something that popped up. It was a 20-mile detour, which means 20 miles back. So now it's 40 miles. Okay? Okay, I'm looking at realistically a $9 per mile all in approximately. But it was still only 350. Okay? So if they don't give you the whole story, if they don't, you know, show you a rate con, but whatever. Rate per mile. It's not the only factor. That's just one factor in, you know, are you going to be profitable? Are you going to be successful? Okay. So as an example, you know, I want to talk about guys who are running shorter runs at a higher rate per mile versus guys running longer runs at a lower rate per mile. And we're just going to run a quick example. Okay. And we're just going to use hotshot numbers here. Now to do this, we have to know our fixed cost. And if you go to a different vehicle, different video, I talk about what does it cost to actually operate your truck? What is your rate per mile? And I hope it's not too loud in here, guys, but you know, what does that cost? And we figured up that my fixed costs are roughly a little over $7,000 a month, okay? Basically, $1,750 a week or $350 a day. That is what my fixed costs are. So we're gonna use those numbers. Your numbers are going to be different, but they may be pretty close. They may be higher. They could be a little lower. They're not going to be a lot lower. Not if you go through some of the other videos and you agree with my way of thinking, okay? So let's just use that. 350 bucks a day. That does not cover fuel. That does not cover pay. That does not cover profit, right? So we're going to go with a 285-mile load at $3.50 a mile. That's a nice paying little load. That's a $1,000 load. 285 miles, 60 miles an hour. You know, basically it's gonna be about 5 hours of driving plus loading, plus loading. You got a 6-7 hour day there, okay? Now we're gonna assume that this is what you're doing for the day, that there's no other load to pick up, because let's say you get loaded at three and it takes you, or not three, you get loaded at, you know, 10 o'clock in the morning, okay? And, you know, or something like that, and you're gonna have 7 hours into this thing. Well, you're not going to be done until 5 o'clock in the afternoon. You're probably not going to get unloaded and get another load. So if you can get 8 to 3 or something like that, okay, that's a nice single day thing. If this is something you can do close to home, be home every night, this might actually be good for you, okay? Also, if this is something you can pick up at the end of the day, okay, you run a load, you're not dropping off until the afternoon, you've already moved, you know, or used a lot of your time, and you only have so much time left. Maybe you've only got 6 hours left on your clock. But you can pick up this load and drop it off tomorrow morning in a good area and in only 6 hours grab this, that makes it a good load too, I think. But let's just go with the guy that's kind of staying local, or maybe he's in a bad area or something like that. Which guy's gonna make more money, okay? So we've got $1,000 a day minus $350 a day for their overhead, 9 miles to the gallon, $4 a gallon, they're gonna burn about $125 in fuel. That's 475 bucks approximately. It's gonna leave them with $523. That's for pay and that's for profit, okay? 523 bucks. They've only had a 7 hour day. approximately. Okay. Now conversely, let's go to a 600 mile load, a load that I'm gonna pick up and get loaded and hit the road maybe 8 o'clock in the morning. 600 miles, that's 10 hours of driving, plus break, plus a little mishap, so you call it 11, that's a full day. So I'm gonna run till the end of my clock. I'll probably have an hour to go in the morning to start it all over again. But you're looking at an 11 hour day run that you can do over and over and over again. 600 miles, but let's say we only get $2.60 a mile for this load, okay? We're gonna burn 66 gallons at $4 a gallon, so about $265 in fuel, okay, as opposed to $125. Our fixed costs are still only $350, okay? 600 miles, $2.60 a mile gives you $1,560. Subtract your $350 fixed cost, subtract your $265, gives you $945, okay? That's $420 a day more than the other guy. Now, you didn't work 7 hours, you worked 13 hours, okay? Because you drove for 10 and a half, you had to get loaded, okay? Now you didn't get unloaded, because that's tomorrow, but you know, whatever. This is where you're running your clock out. When you're pushing hard, you're running your driving hours, you're hoping to get loaded and unloaded in, you know, reasonable amount of time, if I could speak. This is where you're pushing hard, but what does that extra hard push get you? $420 a day. Instead of making $500, I'm making almost $1,000, okay, for pay and payroll. Which one's better? That's only you can decide that, okay? If the short run is something you can do close to home, sleep in your bed every night, see your family, that might be awesome for you, okay? If that's not enough money for you, or maybe you don't have a family, or you know they're older, or whatever your reason is, and you want to have the higher grossing numbers, do the longer runs for the lower rate, okay? You're gonna make more. Now, that same run, if we can get that 260 and we can get it up to 280, at 20 cents a mile, it's $120, okay? The more money you can get per mile, the better, but rate per mile is not the only thing, okay? That is not the only thing. You always have to consider your fixed costs. And then you have to consider, you know, the lifestyle. One's maybe local, one's over the road. What do you like? So rate per mile is not the only thing. I'm just gonna say it one more time because it's just fun to say. Just be mindful of everything else. So hopefully that gets you thinking a little bit about different ways to run the business, different opportunities to not just get stuck on rate per mile. For the guys going, I don't move my truck for less than $3 a mile. Well, I can get you $3 a mile all day long and you're gonna go broke, okay? I'll do it. I can have you moving sea containers for $4 a mile. You're gonna be out of business in a couple months, okay? You know, but hey, you got $4 a mile, you know? Just be mindful that there's more to it than just rate per mile. So as always, guys, I hope you liked the video. If you do, hit that thumbs up. Leave a comment, ask a question. If you agree, thank you, I appreciate it. Especially if you disagree, let me know why. Give me some reasons behind it, okay? If there's something I can learn, I would love it. If there's something I can learn and share with somebody else, I would love it. You know, if somebody truly says, hey, you're wrong, this is why, and they're right, hell, I'll redo the whole damn video. I'll take this first video down, or I'll do clips of it where I say this, and I'll correct myself and go, yep, I was wrong, okay? I'm not too proud for that, guys. I'm here to help. I'm here to learn, and I'm here to enjoy myself. So I hope you're liking the videos. That's it. As always, be safe, and we'll see you out there, guys. Thank you.